Began as a practice of pious pilgrims to Jerusalem who would retrace the final journey of Jesus Christ to Calvary. Later, for the many who wanted to pass along the same route but could not make the trip to Jerusalem, a practice developed that eventually took the form of the 14 stations currently found in almost every church. By reflecting on these stations, we can begin to enter into the Paschal mystery, the suffering, death, and resurrection of Christ, and begin to experience the process of dying and rising into a new life that Christ models for our own lives. To create an atmosphere of welcome and prayer while reflecting on these themes, we have incorporated meditative Taizé music, which aligns with each station. Please join in singing or silently reflect on the text while we move through the service. Taizé has become a model of ecumenism, particularly amongst young people hosting as many as 6,000 a week for the prayerful meetings. Pilgrims that are traveling to Taizé, France, are offered shelter and food in exchange for helping with the common needs of the village and community. Focusing on three periods of commencing prayer each day, participants delve into the meaning of their own spiritual journey, expose their faith commitments, and worship with people from all over the world. We hope that this gathering and experience help explore your own spirituality, connect with the community of faith here at Kemna Catholic, and prepare you to enter into the Paschal mystery of Jesus' passion, death, and resurrection, and the celebration of Easter that follows. Before each station, I will say, "We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you." All will respond, "Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world." Station, Jesus is condemned to death. "We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you."
There you stand before the crown after being beaten. You never deny yourself, yet humbly accept the punishment given to you by those who had witnessed your miracles. It's easy to look at this scene now and think, how could they have accused you and condemned you to death? All you did was love every person you met. Yet, they are not alone in their condemnation of you. How often do I ignore you at school in the person no one wants to talk to? How often do my words condemn you in the way that I speak about others? It was not only the Jews and Pontius Pilate who condemned you, but I stand next to them and shout just as loud, "Crucify him." Jesus, forgive me for the ways in which I condemn and pierce others with my words and actions. Help me to love like you and to learn from your example.
The second station. Jesus carries the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
By now you have endured a sleepless night, the betrayal of your friends, and a beating that is too horrible to fully imagine. You've been whipped, stripped, and spit on by countless faces, some of whom last week treated you like royalty as you entered the city. And now, they hand you a cross to carry. Its weight of it is far more than any number of pounds we can figure, for in carrying the cross, you carry the weight of our sins. How often do I forget that you've carried the load for me? How often do I try to carry things on my own, not allowing you to help me? It was not only the sins of the world that you carried, it was my sin. My selfishness, my pride, my anger, each added more weight to the load. And it was not only my sin you carried, but also my burdens, my worries, my fears, my sadness, my insecurities. Each you carried step by step up towards Golgotha, the place of the skull. Jesus, help me not to forget the load that you carried for me. Give me the strength and the courage to let go of those things that separate me from you.
Come into your kingdom.
third station, Jesus falls for the first time. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
As you walk through the narrow streets, every movement, every jolt burns and reopens your wounds. The pain, along with the weight of the cross, becomes too much and you fall. In boxing, when a fighter falls and hits to beat him to continue, the fight is stopped by the referee. Yet there is no one there to stop the battle that you fight for us. Even though you know what still lies ahead, you do not stop and somehow find the strength to continue. How many times have I fallen in my walk? Too many to count, I'm sure. So many times when I fall, I don't feel like getting back up and trying again. There are too many temptations that I am faced with that felt too fun and easy to do because so many people around me are doing them. Jesus, help me to remember your courage and perseverance when you fell. Give me the courage to get back up when I fall. Help me remember that it is worth it to live as you lived. Surprised that she is there for you. She's always been there for you. Her yes to the Father has been a light in the darkness. And now, here in your darkest hour, she is there. There are so many times when I feel alone in my struggles. It seems that no one understands what I'm going through, especially my parents. But I realize they must. How many times have I hidden things from my parents out of fear of what they would say, or what trouble I would be in when all they want is to love me? Jesus, help me to remember that I'm never alone in my struggles. Help me to see my parents as you saw yours. Help me know their love for me, and when things are hard between us, help me to remember the light of your mother in my life.
Simon, a Cyrenian, out of the crowd to help you carry the cross. He follows behind you, walking in your steps, helping you move forward. You press on, knowing that the worst is yet to come. How often do I pass up an opportunity to help someone in need? Do I let what others may think of me stop me from reaching out? Jesus, open my ears to hear the ways that you call me to serve. Help me follow Simon's example of helping others. Help me to know what it means to be a true and faithful servant.
Remembering your love and your faithfulness, you get up, and now with your wounds, full of dirt, and each step embedding in it. Deeper, you keep going. How many times have I failed to follow through on my own promises? Or worse yet, how often have I lied to even to the people I care about? Do I remember your faithfulness even when I fall? Jesus, help me to believe in your faithfulness and love for me. Give me the grace to follow through on my word to others. Help me to be a person of integrity. And because of the beating you have endured, you already look like you should not be breathing at all. Yet, at this moment, consumed by death, you speak words of life and say, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me." Do I listen to your words in my life? How often have the things I've watched or listened to led me away from you? Have I allowed the gospel of life to reign in my heart? Jesus, help me to listen to your words of life. Show me ways that I can put you first.
How often have I chosen to sin rather than to follow your way?
Was it my sin that became too heavy and that you fell for this third time? Jesus, help me to follow your ways. Help me to remember your victory over my sin. Give me the grace to recognize my sin and the desire to sin no more. Do I find my own self-worth and self-identity by the clothes I wear or the way that I look? Jesus, help me to look past the outside of others. Help me not to judge them by how they look or what they wear. Help me to find my self-worth and identity in you. Jesus, I'm sorry for nailing you to the cross with my own sin. Help me to seek your forgiveness and mercy for the times that I sin.
Amen.
12th station. Jesus dies on the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Above your head is the inscription, King of the Jews. As you use every last ounce of life left in your body to lift your left in you to lift your body so that you can speak, you do not look apart. Yet every word out of your mouth is one of love, truly from another kingdom. The faces of all humanity must flash before your eyes as one by one you recount whom you were doing this for. And finally you say, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. It is finished. You breathe your last and it looks as though this is the end. Jesus, help me never forget your love for me. Help me to know that you died for me. Fill my heart with comfort in knowing that I never suffered anything you don't understand.
The 13th station. Jesus is taken down from the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
The right arms that held you in this world are also the last. Your mother was told a sword would pierce her heart the day she presented you as an infant to the Father. Now, as she holds your body that is mangled beyond recognition, she sees not only the man she now holds, but also the child she held, and her heart is pierced. Your comfort to her will come, but at this moment, she is only the Father to be with her in her sorrow and pain. All hope seems gone. How many times have I lost hope in you? How often have I doubted your ability to be God in my life over all things? Jesus, help me to trust in you. Help me to place all of my hope in you and give me peace in knowing that you are the Lord over all things.
Thank you.
14th station, Jesus is placed in the tomb. We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. You are laid to rest by Joseph of Arimathea, Mary Magdalene, Mary your mother, and a few other women. As your body is anointed, Mary Magdalene remembers your eyes penetrating her heart. Tears stream down her face, along with the others there as they too remember your love. They wrap your body in clean linens and lay it in a new tomb. The stone is rolled over the entrance, and now it is surely the end. Up to this point, death is final. While those you have lived with, laughed with, and cried with are in their heightened sorrow, believing all is over, you are conquering sin and death. How many times has death felt like the end? When I've lost a loved one, it can be so hard to remember your victory. How often do I miss the opportunities to say I love you to those special people in my life? Do my family and friends know how I feel about them? Jesus, help me always remember that death is not the end. Give me the strength to say the words I love you to those people in my life that I do love. Help me to love every person, not just in words, but also with my actions. Jesus, I love you, I need you, and I trust you. Amen.